fork tires, little tires we put on, and that's how we're able to fit them in there. It's like a sardine can.
Now, another thing that's real neat about what you get to drive is you've got one of these trucks out there that instantly captivates the attention of the fan, the ice cream man. You know, everyone knows the ice cream truck, but you've got the biggest ice cream truck around.
Yeah, kids love it. I mean, they come up, they just want to crawl all over it and get into tires. So it's a lot of fun. You know, kids come up, it's really a lot of fun.
Now, earlier this month, you're coming off a real big weekend where you swept racing for an entire weekend worth of events. Get some real tough competition, but here tonight you got your boss, J.R. McNeal with Razin Kane, and you've got the bounty hunter with Darren Migues. So it's going to be tough competition here in Fort Smith tonight.
Oh yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun. It's a tight course, so hopefully a truck will slide around pretty good, and you know, we'll see what happens.
Now, one of the things we're doing tonight is a little different than a lot of folks have maybe seen, but it's something we've been having a lot of fun with on the All-Star Monster Truck Tour this year, is we're doing obstacle course racing, where these guys are going to come out here, attack the track, and go for the best time. Is that a style of the racing that you've done so far this year? And what do you think of it and the challenges that come with it versus regular side-by-side racing?
Mentally, it's a lot more stressful because, you know, you're beating yourself. When you're racing another truck, you know, your odds are a little bit better because the other driver can mess up a little bit more. So I don't know, I like the side-by-side racing or Chicago style. You know, that's my favorite, but obstacle course is a lot of fun.
All right, TJ, now tell me this though. You've won yourself a couple of wheelie contests already this year, standing that thing absolutely straight up and down. What do you think? Are we gonna see the ice cream man on his tailgate here tonight?
I'm first up, so hopefully we'll see what happens.
All right, guys. Well, hey, it's time to start getting you guys. I want to hear you make some noise. How about it for TJ Tripp and the Ice Cream Man? Make some noise for Fort Smith!
Ice cream!
All right, now I think a lot of the fans are probably going to pick up on this as we introduce the drivers' names, because you share a last name with one of our other drivers here. So why don't you tell us how it is you got interested in driving monster trucks?
I started with my husband over there. We've been together probably over 20 years, and we used to go see monster truck shows, and he got started in to extreme racing, and then he asked me one night if I wanted to give it a shot, and I said sure.
Well, now you're on this fourth time of giving it a shot here tonight, but it's actually the first time this year you've had a chance to be behind the wheel because of the busy schedule. What were your impressions from your first couple shows behind the wheel, and what are your goals for a night show?
The goal is just to keep it on four and not break, because it would be a long ride home.
Now tell me this, there's a few husband-wife driver combos in Monster Truck. What are the stakes here? Is it he's going to be doing the dishes in the laundry if he brings it, or how does that work?
You know, we really haven't talked about that. I just want to get through the show and let him do his thing and me just do my thing.
All right, fans. Well, hey, ladies in the house, time to make some noise. How about it for Kelly Migues and Outlaw? And, you know, when you look at it, and look at this lineup, you're expected right there on the same level as Bounty Hunter to win tonight. And I know that's a lot of pressure in some instances, so tell us what it's like to come here as one of the favorites.
Well, not only is it pressure, but I know Darren, he's an awesome driver, and TJ's doing really good. So my head, you know, every week it gets tougher and tougher running with these guys. But I think we're going to get it done. You know, Jimmy Creighton's a great guy. He's got great trucks. So, you know, we'll see what our trucks can do.
You know, Jared, we've had the pleasure of knowing you from, you know, the very first show you guys actually did. We were out there with you at that show. And it's been amazing watching the team grow. Just from your standpoint as kind of a team owner and what you've built and all the goals that you've set and achieved, what's the next thing you're trying to knock down in this sport?
Well, this next year, I want to be in the World Finals. You know, I was in Vegas this year doing the Young Guns. I would love to see TJ, you know, my teammate, do the Young Guns and me be in the World Finals. And I've already told Monster Jam, you know, that I'm, you know, I got four bodies, I got all the spare parts, and that's how hard I'm going to run. So that's my plans to be in the World Finals, both of us, actually.
Now, that's the big goal for the winter season. But once you get outdoors in summer and fall, you go to one of our biggest stars on the All-Star Monster Truck Tour. And you guys have been with us for several events, racing against the best that Monster Trucks have to offer, including Bounty Hunter and a lot of the other trucks we've had this summer. And you guys have picked up some wins on the tour. What have you thought of the tour so far? And you're here with us for the big finale this weekend.
Well, it's great. Brian's a great guy, all-star. You know, he gave us a shot, you know, in our beginning. And it's always awesome to come out here. And one thing that's different between Monster Jam and being here is there's no pressure. you can come out here and let it loose and have a good time.
Well, that's great, because I know all these fans are going to be looking forward to having a good time with you here tonight. Tell these fans what they're going to see. We've got wheelie, obstacle course racing, and freestyle coming up here tonight. Which one's your favorite, and what are you going to show these guys tonight?
Well, I like it all, but freestyle is my, I love doing it. I get real nervous, and as soon as I put the helmet on, I get helmetitis. I put the strap on, start it up, and I don't remember anything except when I get out of the truck. So I plan to run really hard. Darren's been here to bring his game.
Well, a little track stop started off already. Man, let's get up to the chair of the field and bring Kane and Darren. Nice. What are you going to show these Fort Smith fans tonight?
Well, you know, I just want to start out. I could really care less what that guy over there has to say that drives Razin Kane. All he is a bunch of hot air. You guys will notice that tonight when he drives. He really doesn't do anything. He makes a lot of noise, goes around all the cars. He's not that good of a driver. He thinks he is. Somebody told him he was one time, and now he thinks he is. I don't worry about him. I don't worry about nothing. You know what? I come out here and I drive this truck and I have a blast. And I'll tell you what, when I leave here, you fans are going to make sure you have the best show you can possibly get tonight. I guarantee that.
Well, the trash talking moving right on up here in the pit party. And if you know Darren Migues, he's probably got one of the driest sense of humor out there. But it's a friendly rivalry, and even though he's joking, he definitely does mean that he's going to take down Razin Kane here tonight. Now, Darren, tell me this. Wheelie contest is the first thing out. That kind of sets the bar for the whole night. What is it that takes for a good wheelie contest effort?
You know what? I tell you what I love about our two trucks. You know, the Iron Outlaw truck and this Bounty Hunter truck. I can get both of these trucks to stand completely vertical. And if you all notice the back of Outlaw, I drove that last weekend, and I managed to get paint 2 feet up on the roof. That means I got it that far back in a wheelie contest to do that. I'm gonna see if I can't do that this old Bounty truck.
Well, we'll be looking forward to seeing that, no doubt. Now, racing on the All-Star Tour is a little different than it is at some others because it's obstacle course racing. You've got several different types of jumps, and it's a long run. What is it that takes to really put down a good time and try and win an obstacle course?
You know what, you gotta be smooth. I mean, you can come in here and you can drive as fast as you want, but that's not what's gonna win this. It's gonna take a smooth, consistent driver to get through this. And I've looked at this track, you know what, this is right up this truck's alley. This truck's got a locker front and rear. This thing loves the corner, it loves to pull itself around. So I look for this truck to turn some good time tonight. But you know what, you can't take anything away from any of these guys. We've all been doing this long enough. We all know what to do. We all know how each other run. So it's going to be a good one tonight, that's for sure.
All right, now the last competition that these guys are going to see tonight is the one that everyone looks forward to all night long, and that's the all-out freestyle competition. And if there's one thing that this team, this truck, and you are known for, it's freestyle.
Yeah, you know, it is one of our favorite things, but, you know, my all-time favorite is I just like to drive around the waves. I don't want to go out and hit these cars because then I start to get scared, and when I get scared, I don't drive good. But you know what? I will drive this truck into the ground, and it doesn't matter if I got to shove it in the trail at the forklift tonight. I got 3 days to get it back together just like I always do, and we'll do it. It doesn't matter. We're here to put on a show, and that's what you guys are going to see tonight.
Well, I'm going to ask you one more thing, Darren. That's kind of unique about this show. There's only been three other shows where this has happened. Your wife, Kelly Megan, is going to be driving Iron Outlaw tonight. Now, what would happen if she managed to take you down here tonight and take the win over the Bounty Hunter?
You know what? I'd be a proud husband, I guarantee that. You know, she's been wanting to drive. I let her drive as much as we can, and I figured this was a perfect show for her. And you know what? No matter what, she gets that truck to the show tonight, I'll still be a proud husband. And I'll tell you what, if she does beat me, I'll fix her drinks all night.
Well, there you go, fans. Let's give it up for Darren Migues and the Bounty Hunter.
I almost stepped into you right there.
got to do. Okay?
No, you're right.
Will it go?
No, that's far as it
goes. No, you're going the wrong way. You're going out. Go in with it.
That's good. Alright.
One. Two. Three.
Thank you. Buddy, what's in the box?
Oh, that's my speed demon. I bought it from this guy. He said it'd give my car more power. Oh, that? He drinks a lot of gas!
You wanted more power. Wouldn't this have been smarter?
Yes!
E3 spark plugs DiamondFIRE technology delivers superior power and exceptional fuel efficiency.
Thank you.
We'll do some on this side.
Up higher now, we'll suck this one down and level the fuck out. The truck was leaning a little bit too far to the right. We had to adjust the sway bar and we clocked the arms. It's kind of hard in a small area coming around to hit the ramp right. So usually you land wrong because you're in that momentum that way. So that's all right. We got it ready for freestyle.
We're in Fort Smith, Arkansas. Last show for All-Star Monster Trucks. Just won a wheelie contest a minute ago. I think I got like third in racing out of four trucks. Ain't bad, I guess. Darren Migues driving Bounty Hunter spanked me. So fun show. Let's see what happens freestyle.